Very heart-touching message, Remembering the Dead, by Shaikh Muhammad Zewada, Imam Masjid Ameen, Newlands, Wellington, New Zealand.
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillahi الذي احتفظ لنفسه بالخلود والبقاء وكتب على جميع خلقه الموت والفناء. سبحانه وتعالى قيوم السماوات والأرض الذي يبقى بعد فناء كل شيء. يقول تعالى: كل من عليها فان ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام. ويقول سبحانه وتعالى لحبيبه ورسوله محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم: إنك ميت وإنهم ميتون. ويقول له أيضا: أفإن مت فهم الخالدون. ويقول الله سبحانه وتعالى: كل نفس ذائقة الموت وإنما توفون أجوركم يوم القيامة فمن زحزح عن النار وأدخل الجنة فقد فاز وما الحياة الدنيا إلا متاع الغرور. Brothers and sisters, we are here today to see our service. Every one of us should look at this brother who left our world, the world of deception, the world of confusion, the world of fakeness, the world of reality, the world of the truth. He left our world to the world of the truth. Every one of us should see himself or herself in the same place and think about this place. Look at this place, how tight it is, how narrow it is, how dark it is. People before him and people after him will keep going to the ground or to the tummy of the ground until no one will be left on the face of earth. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be always there forever, because he is Al-Hayy Al-Qayyum, the one who will never die, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But any other being, any other living creatures will have to die, sooner or later. And the moment we leave this world, we start our second journey, our next journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't think of the day of Qiyamah, the day of judgment, to be too far. It is too close. The moment your soul departs from your body, this is the time when you start to present yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for questioning. Allah said, إِنَّهُمْ يَعَوْنَهُ بَعِيدًا وَنَرَهُ قَرِيبًا. They think it's too far. I am still too young. I'm still very healthy. I eat good food. I receive good healthy care. But the reality is that this is as close to every one of us as his shoes is close to his body, as close to his feet. It is not too far. Young people die, old people die, rich people die, poor people die, educated, non-educated. Everyone has to die. This is the reality that no one denies. But the question that we have to ask ourselves when we see this kind of situation, are we prepared for that? Am I ready to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give an answer to this question? Somebody met a scholar, a spiritual scholar or an educator. His name is Al-Fudayl ibn Ayyad. The Al-Fudayl, the scholar, asked the man, and think, listen carefully to this conversation. There is somebody of a knowledge, a kind of knowledge that is missing from our world today, the material knowledge. It is not the material knowledge, the spiritual knowledge that we don't have. He asked him, how old are you? He said, I'm 60 years of age. I'm 60 years old. He said, yeah, it does mean that 60 years ago you started your journey going back to Allah. You are almost about to reach. He said, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. I didn't think of it like that. I've started my journey 60 years ago. I mean, it's not much to go, not much left. So what should I do? He said, you just make your best to do the best or to do the good things in the remaining part of your life. Allah will forgive whatever bad things have been done in the past part of your life. It is always open for the people to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The door is always there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never push anyone out of his door. We might be busy from Allah, busy with our material world, busy with our own stuff. That's fine. As long as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is on the top of your list of priority, then you are okay. But if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not in our calendar, the worship of Allah is not in our schedule, our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not there. If this is the case, then this is very alarming. It is very alarming. So this brother here have been in our life, in our world for some time, and now he is left, no return. He will be there until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala call everyone for reckoning, for hisab. Right now there is a conversation taking place. This conversation taking place will take place when every one of us go to the same kind of grave, to the same grave. This conversation is invisible for us, unhearable for us, but it's a reality. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, when somebody go down to his grave, Allah sent two angels to him. They will ask him three questions, simple, easy questions. But guess what? Those three questions cannot be answered by so many well-educated people, because the answer at that time is not about what you know. It's about what you have done in your life. Your actions will give the answer. The first question is, who is your Lord? Who is your Rabb? Who is your Master? Who was your Ilah, your God? You worshipped him. Is Allah your God, or money, or position, or life, or whatever material thing you have in your life as your God? Who is your God? Man Rabbuk, wa ma deenik, what is your religion? What is your faith? What is your life style? Is it Islam or something else? The third question is, what do you think of Muhammad? If he doesn't know Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Rasulullah, he won't have an answer to give. The simple answer is, my Rabb is Allah, my deen is Islam, my religion is Islam, Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, simple, done. Simple answers. But in reality, not everyone will be able to answer this question. Until you have good connection with Allah, then your tongue will say, Allah is my Rabb. You have good intention, good relationship with Islam. Islam is in your life. You will say, my religion is Islam. You have some kind of communication, good connection with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then you will answer, Muhammad is Rasulullah, is a messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. After a few minutes, we're going to leave him here alone and go back to our own homes, our own businesses, our own life. And the only one will be talking to him after this conversation is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What do you think? What do you reckon? What will be the question? What will be the conversation between him and Allah, his creator, his maker, the one who brought him to this life and the one who took him back to him? He will say to him, Abdi, oh my servant, my slave. Did we forget this fact? We are slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I just am reminding myself and everyone. We are slaves. We don't have much options. Abdi, my slave, raja'u wa tarakuk. They return back home and they left you alone. وَفِي التُّرَابِ دَفَنُوكَ. They take you out of your comfort zone, from your bedding, from your linen, from your blankets, from your warm place, to a grave, to dirt and dust. وَإِنْ ظَلُّوا مَعَكَ لَمْ يَنْفَعُوكَ. Even if they stay with you, they're not gonna benefit you. وَلَيْسَ لَكَ هُنَا إِلَّا أَنَا. No one can benefit you here except me, Allah. وَأَنَا الْحَيِّ الَّذِي لَا أَمُوتُ. I'm the one who will never die. He will be always there, subhanahu wa ta'ala. كل نفس ذائقة الموت. Every single soul, every single nafs, every single life shall taste the death. وإنما توفون أجوركم يوم القيامة. You will get paid in full on the day of judgment. Don't expect from anyone, expect from Allah. Do the good thing, but don't expect from the people. People will disappoint you. Only expect from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولذلك, that's why Allah said, وإنما توفون أجوركم يوم القيامة. You will be rewarded on the day of judgment. فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ. Your destination, your ultimate goal is to be removed from the hellfire and to be admitted in the Jannah. We have to keep on our eyes on this reality. There is two destinations waiting for every one of us, whether eternal abide in the hellfire or eternal residence in the Jannah, inshaAllah. We have to work hard to get a place in the Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this is the real success. It's not to hold a high degree, it's not to hold a high position, it's not to collect a lot of money, it's not to be handsome and smart, and not to be very famous and popular. The real success is to make your way to the Jannah. Because nothing worth, if somebody leaves this world and he was the best one, the most spoken about one, but he will go straight away to hell. What kind of benefit he will get if this is his destination or her destination? What will be harmful for anyone if he leaves this world with all the trouble there and make his way straight away to the Jannah? What pain, what harm he should be complaining or suffering from? No harm, no pain, because he's going to make his way to the Jannah. It's a reality. It's a fact. It's the truth. that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us. And guess what? We have placed him in dirt. We have seen the dirt. We have touched the dirt and the soil by our own hands. But if the person is good and have good connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this dirt, by the power of Allah, by the power of Allah, will turn into a garden of Jannah. Piece of Jannah, it will be a garden. It will be the super flesh place ever on the face of earth, where fruits are there, life is there, happiness is there. It looks like dirt, but in reality it can be a Jannah. But on the other side, if somebody is bad, if somebody is disconnected from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and furnished his place with silk and fill his grave with gold, still this place will be a bit of hellfire. Rasulullah said the grave could be either a piece of Jannah, a bit of Jannah, or Jannah, a paradise, or could be a hellfire. Make your own place before you move to it. Build your own house before you move to it. And that is our house here until we get to the Jannah, inshallah. This is our permanent place. This is our permanent place on earth until we get called out. Work for this day. Work for this place. Work for this destination. It is not too far. It is too close. Too close. And we have seen in this community a lot of people die very young. Not too far, long ago, there was only one row. Now, mashallah, we have almost completed four rows. Many, many people passed away in this very small community. So this is not far away from any one of us. All what we can help this brother with is dua, as Rasulullah ﷺ asked us. Make dua for your brother because he is being asked right now. And if you make dua for him, somebody will be there when you are in need for his dua to make dua for you when you are in the same place. Let's make dua and we request Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him. Ya Allah, O Allah, forgive him and admit him into the Jannah. Ya Allah, we ask you to forgive him and admit him into the Jannah. Ya Allah, bless him and shower him with your forgiveness. Ya Allah, take him straight away to the Jannah without any preceding azab or hisab. Ya Allah, we ask you to forgive all of us. We ask you to shower all of us with your mercy. We ask you to pardon all of us and forgive all of our sins and mistakes. We ask you to fill our life with happiness and with pleasure. We ask you to fill our life with goodness, and we ask you to take all hardships and difficulties from our life. We ask you to give us good health and good life in this world and the world to come, inshallah. Ya Allah, Allahumma arhamhu wa aghfir lahu ya rabbal alameen. Allahumma aafihi wa afu anhu. Allahumma jafi al-ard an jambay. Allahumma wassi' mudkhala. Allahumma wassi' mudkhala. اللهم اجعل قبره روضة من رياض الجنة ولا تجعله حفرة من حفر النار. اللهم لا تجعل قبره حفرة من حفر النار. اللهم جازه بالإحسان إحسانا وبالإساءة عفوا وغفرانا. اللهم تجاوز عن سيئاته. اللهم ضاعف في حسناته. اللهم ضاعف في حسناته. اللهم املأ قبره نورا. اللهم املأ قبره نورا. اللهم املأ قبره نورا واملأ قبورنا نورا حين نلجأ إليها يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحمنا إذا صرنا إلى ما صار إليه. اللهم ارحمنا إذا صرنا إلى ما صار إليه. اللهم ارحمنا تحت الأرض وفوق الأرض ويوم العرض عليك يا رب العالمين. اللهم آمن روعاتنا واغفر زلاتنا وتجاوز عن سيئاتنا وتب علينا جميعا توبة نصوحا يا رب العالمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
From Makara Cemetery, Wellington, New Zealand, Agam Jaya, New Zealand Channel, reporting.